Buckingham Palace has unveiled the full programme to mark Queen Elizabeth II's Platinum Jubilee. Her Majesty, 95, will become the first British monarch to celebrate the milestone, as she marks 70 years of service. Throughout the year, the Queen and members of the royal family will travel around the country, undertaking a variety of engagements to mark the occasion. On Monday, the palace released the full programme ahead of the celebrations. It includes parades, concerts, and a bank holiday. It is not clear which events Her Majesty will attend following orders to rest by doctors last year. Celebrations are set to kick off on January 10 with the Platinum Pudding Competition. Run by Fortnum and Mason, it seeks to find a dish which can be dedicated to the Queen's historic milestone. Recipes will be judged by an expert panel, including Dame Mary Berry. The Queen's Green Canopy Initiative will continue to plant new trees to present to her at the end of the year. From May 12 to 15, more than 500 horses and 1,000 performers are expected to take part in a show in the grounds of Windsor Castle. This will take the audience through royal history, from Elizabeth I to the present day. The rest of the celebrations are expected to take place later in the year. June 2 will mark the first day of the special four-day bank holiday when the Queen's Birthday Parade, also known as Trooping the Colour, takes place in a Horse Guards Parade. On the same day, the UK, Channel Islands, Isle of Man and UK Overseas Territories will come together to light a beacon. The beacon will be lit at the same time as the principal beacon at Buckingham Palace. On June 3, a service of thanksgiving for the Queen's reign will be held at St Paul's Cathedral, ahead of the star-studded Platinum Party at the Palace on Saturday, June 4. The party is expected to bring together some of the world's biggest names in entertainment. On June 5, street parties are being planned across the UK, with neighbours expected to join together for food and fun to celebrate the Platinum Jubilee. It will mark the end of the bank holiday. Experts fear Prince Harry and Meghan Markle may work to craft some reason for the royal not to attend the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Royal commentator and expert Jonathan Saccadotti made this admission during his interview with Christina Ross and Christina Garibaldi from the Royal Yes podcast. Performers are yet to be named, neither does the participants, but it is being billed as bringing together some of the world's biggest names in entertainment. However, experts fear Prince Harry and Meghan Markle may work to craft some reason for the royal not to attend the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Royal commentator and expert Jonathan Saccadotti made this admission during his interview with Christina Ross and Christina Garibaldi from the Royal Yes podcast. He started it all off by admitting, "Meghan will probably be in attendance if traveling and everything is okay with the kids and everything like that. So this will be the first time that Meghan and Harry have come back. Obviously Harry came back for the statue unveiling, but this is the first time that the Queen will hopefully meet her great-granddaughter." Mr. Saccadotti also said, "This could be the case. I have heard some rumors that maybe Prince Harry will come back without Meghan. It is notable that she hasn't been back during those visits he's made. She hasn't really been back to the UK as far as I know, since they left, and she may sense that she is not the most popular person here with the public. So it might be that they'll find a reason for her not to come. Could be the children, it could be that they just don't want to steal the focus away from those celebrations and the Queen. But of course, whatever they do, unfortunately for them and for the royal family, it will steal some focus, because if she doesn't come, everyone will be talking about that. If she does come, everyone will be talking about that. So whatever happens, I think there's going to be plenty of discussion of how their relationship is with the Queen and the wider royal family. And that means that this could be an opportunity for them to come back and appear magnanimous, and really just throw themselves into the celebrations and keep a low profile. If they remember how to do that, I'm not sure. Or it could be a moment that they act diplomatically and maybe Harry comes back that Meghan doesn't, and then the celebrations might go on after a bit of gossip column style coverage of that. Sandringham and Balmoral will also be open for residents and visitors to enjoy the celebrations across the long weekend.
Thank you.
It will mark the end of the bank holiday. Experts fear Prince Harry and Meghan Markle may work to craft some reason for the royal not to attend the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Royal commentator and expert Jonathan Sacerdoti made this admission during his interview with Christina Ross and Christina Garibaldi from the Royal Yes podcast. Performers are yet to be named, neither does the participants, but it is being billed as bringing together some of the world's biggest names in entertainment. However, experts fear Prince Harry and Meghan Markle may work to craft some reason for the royal not to attend the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Royal commentator and expert Jonathan Sacerdoti made this admission during his interview with Christina Ross and Christina Garibaldi from the Royal Yes podcast. He started it all off by admitting, Meghan will probably be in attendance if traveling and